We're in the thick of the baseball playoffs in the state of Arizona for Division I and started off at Hamilton High School, where the number 8-seeded Huskies took on a Corona del Sol team, a number 24 seed, fresh off an upset of Tucson earlier in the week. Hamilton got a strong outing from Parker Gallegos, but was in a jam in the top of the first. With two on, Gallegos gets a ground ball from Mike Gammon. Mitch Ney at third throws him out to end the inning. Gallegos threw 6 2/3, gave up 6 hits, and only 1 earned run. Hamilton would be on the attack in the bottom of the first. With a runner on second, senior Mitch Ney turns on an inside pitch, sending it into left field. Skylar Palermo would come around to score, and it's 1-0 Huskies. Still in the first with two on, it's senior Garrett Enweiler gets that ball full of metal. 3-run bomb for Enweiler broke this one open, making it 4-0. Hamilton would go on to win it 9-1 the final. Huskies moving on to face the number 1-seed Pinnacle Pioneers on Thursday. Down the road, it was a wild game at Mesquite High School between the Wildcats and Red Mountain. The Mountain Lions erupted for 4 in the first, but the Wildcats would claw back. Down 1 run in the sixth, it's junior Brad Holland who shoots that one right back up the middle. Chugging around third and scoring is Casey Howard, who slides into home, and we were all tied up going into a wild seventh. Despite losing their lead, Red Mountain would respond. After a double from Aaron Smith, John Havard steps up to the plate, takes that pitch opposite field. Flying home is Smith, and the Red Mountain Mountain Lions retake the lead. But it was short-lived. Mesquite, already with 1 run home to tie it in the bottom of the seventh, saw Casey Howard step into the box with the winning run 90 feet away. Howard goes with the pitch, getting it past the second baseman. Howard is the hero, and the Wildcats get a walk-off win, 7-6 the final. After the game, Casey Howard explained how his team wouldn't go away.
We're a fighting team and never give up, so just kept clawing at the team and got the win.
Mesquite moves on to face Sandra Day O'Connor on Thursday. From Mesquite High School, this is Jared Cohen for ProsToPreps.com.